we get to the blanket certification requirement. So here is one of the rare ones, and I don't see too many of those, but pretty much the blanket certification is listed in this section, right? Usually you want to limit this to this numbers, and then those paragraphs, subparagraphs, etc., etc., usually you leave it out there. But as the experience has shown, it may not be always a prudent idea. So let's go back to the rule. So first thing, 121. First thing to note is we're dealing with this particular statement. This one. And you start, if you have this text with you, you start with this one, then you go A, then you go down, then you go, so this is I, small I, this is double small I, and then you go over here. So it's pretty cumbersome, right? And what's exacerbated by the examiners as they present this problem on the exam, this actually came up on the exam. I didn't make any changes whatsoever. Is that they go into the detail and see they include this one, then they include this one which is more specific, then they include this one which is more specific. This one you rarely see. But because they include this, I incorporated this in the outline as something to be mindful of, and even underlined it so you guys pay attention to this. Certification should be filed with the port director of the port, so it's port by port, no headquarters. Certification filing should be made on the letterhead of certifying firm. So it's mostly geared to the companies, right, not to individuals. Although individuals can also enter stuff for themselves. But this is not the standard. Certification must list the products covered by name, HTS number, notice it's subheading number level, so meaning that to 6 or 8 digit level. So the HTS classification for imports usually is done at the 10 digit level. Here, 6 or 8 will suffice. Certification must identify foreign supplier by name, address, and must be signed by an authorized person. Who is an authorized person? Usually it is the importer of record, because the importer of record is responsible for pretty much everything that goes that can go wrong and may go wrong with a particular import. So now, when importing commodities, first of all, start with a question first, right? When you have this type of problem, start with a question to save yourself some time so you know what's going on. Forget the fact pattern, go to the question first. Which citation outlines the reporting requirement for a blanket certification? All right, so, and you have those regulations. So if you have no clue what is going on, of course, it is a good idea to start going to the CFR and seeing the provision. As you know, if you are provided 3 answer choices with the same section, which is different paragraphs, one is most general, more specific, and more specific, then, of course, under the best answer rule, you go with the most specific one. And then, kind of to check your work, you check the fact pattern, which is here at the beginning. Customs sometimes flips it back and forth. So you, one way you can control it and control your time is by looking out for that question mark, question sign. When importing commodities that are regulated under TFCA, a certifying statement must be presented prior to release through, unless the importer has blanket certification on file with customs. All right, so pretty much it's a statement of law. And most specific one, as we saw, is this one. So this is the best answer choice under the best answer rule. And in fact, it was what customs decided to give a score to everyone who picked it.